Hello, Del Ballou here, working on one of my reclaimed paintings, and I'm working this time on a painting of Claude Monet's Lily Pond on Monet's property in Giverny, France, and I'm working from a photograph that I took. I'm not sure if you can see that. But if you'll notice in the photograph, there's a bright light, bright sunlight on the lily pads, and so they're pretty much washed out. So I'm diminishing that light somewhat. But as I have said many times, if you've seen my videos in the past, that this is my painting, and I can do it however I choose. And so I'm choosing to make it a little less bright. And I'm using a variety of green paints. And I mixed them up ahead of time. You can see that. So that I have them ready so that I can sort of mix and mingle on these lily pads until I get to a point where I'm satisfied with the way they look. And you can't really see this color very well because I've already done some of these medium values already. But like a lot of things in painting, a lot of little details, so sort of add things by degrees based on what looks good at the time. And if it doesn't look good, don't do it. You can always come back and change your mind. And I need a few of these lily pads that are floating around. I decided to videotape this because I kind of like having someone to talk to while I'm working. It's not necessary for me. Painting is a pretty solitary kind of venture, but as a college professor, English professor that is, I found that I sort of need an audience. It helps me gauge what it is I'm doing. Of course, I can see the looks on students' faces in class, whereas I can't see your face, but I'm not giving you a grade either, so not a bad thing. Lily pads, when they're fresh and new and green, for the most part, lay pretty flat. But the ones in Monet's pond, in my photograph, are curled up all over the place. So mine can be all over the place too. Just put one right out here. Let him float around. always good to remember that you need good contrast in your paintings. By contrast, I mean, of course, lights and darks. Otherwise, your painting is going to be too somber, maybe even boring. And as I looked at Monet's style, I realized he had many styles in the way he painted the lily pads and the lilies on them. So I do not fear retribution if I don't get it right. Well, certainly Monet is not going to quibble. But Monet was, like most artists, somewhat experimenting with a style that was really new for him and other artists of the turn of the century. So he was breaking new ground. And I dare say we're all pretty much breaking new ground. Going back to reestablish some of my darks around those medium areas, medium tones. I still have to put the reflections in my pond. But this pretty much needs to come first. I don't know if you can see in the video, but this dark color that I'm putting in now has some alizarin crimson. So it's dark, but it's not dark green. And that's pretty much okay too. So as I always say, it's my painting. I'm going back to some dark green. Because whether you can see it or not, there's every color in everything. Because color is in light. Sometimes in the late afternoon, the light seems to wash out color, which is why you really shouldn't take photographs in the late afternoon. I think about all those years I used to take photographs or be in photographs where people always made me look at the sun, the bright sun, and that's probably the very worst Well, it certainly makes ugly pictures because we all tend to squint when we're facing bright light. And just in case any of you need to know about photographing your artwork, the best place and the best time to do it is in the shade. In sort of early afternoon. And you need to have your painting stationary on a stand of some kind. And you need to stand directly in front of your painting. Or at least if you have your camera on a tripod, your camera lens and your painting need to be at exactly the same angle. Otherwise, your painting is going to be distorted in your photograph. And you can look around the edges of your painting in your camera lens to see if everything is lining up correctly. And of course, if you do it in the right light, you don't want to use a flash. So, no extra charge for that. Like I said, if you did that out in the sunshine, it would be bad news. Okay, I'm going to call that finished for right now because I don't have any more paint mixed up. Okay, that's coming along. It's a way to go yet. Okay, well, thank you for watching. Thank you for being my audience today. Bye-bye now.